Everyone, so today we are doing a very exciting video. As you can see behind me, I am surrounded by garbage. Why, you may ask? Well, I will tell you. So today is a very exciting day here on YouTube, and you may have noticed a lot of content about oceans and garbage being posted, and that is because Mark Rober and Mr. Beast, who are YouTubers here on this platform, I'm sure you guys probably have heard of them before, they're very popular. But they have designed a campaign called Team Seas to raise $30 million to remove 30 million pounds of garbage from the beaches, rivers, and oceans. So obviously when I heard about this project, I was really excited and I knew that I wanted to be a part of it. So I thought of this concept that I feel like kind of intertwines with it, where I'm like making a drag outfit out of garbage. I know that like a lot of this is actually recycling, so don't worry. I most definitely do recycle. I actually have a really extensive recycling program that we do here, where we sort everything and we take it to the recycling center and have to sort it there. But for the sake of making an outfit, I knew that I would need cardboard, so I kind of looked at it from the perspective of like if you didn't recycle, because a lot of people I know actually don't recycle at all, which if you don't recycle, I suggest recycling. But it's a really good way to reuse some of the waste that you would normally create. But anyway, so this is garbage and recycling, but we're making an outfit out of it today. And as you guys know, we always do a charity portion in every video. So today that is going to be Team Seas for sure. And on top of the $500 donation we usually do, I'm gonna be matching that. So basically, together, we are taking 1,000 pounds of garbage out of the ocean. And I don't even know how much 1,000 pounds looks like. I'm gonna search it and see if there's a picture. Okay, I found this picture, which maybe this is what 1 pound of trash looks like. So basically you can times this picture by 1,000, and that's how much by donating we're removing from the ocean together. This is a huge campaign. I can't even imagine if this works, how big of an impact this is gonna make on so many different things, like including sea life. So if you guys wanna donate, I will definitely link Team Seas down below. Let's build something out of all this garbage, shall we? Should we do a garbage haul before we get started? So since I have been moving, I will say I've created probably more garbage and recycling than I would normally create, just with all of the packing boxes and ordering new things and stuff like that. And I've known I've been doing this concept for a little while, so I kind of told everybody in the house, like, if you make garbage and it's not like covered in food or something, put it in this spot, because I wanted to accumulate all the pristine garbage for this, because I didn't really want like dirty paper towels, because I don't feel like that would be very sanitary to make clothes out of.
This is the clean garbage.
Okay, but here is everything we're gonna be dealing with. As you can see, lots of boxes, which I think will be important for the base, but then we have more fun types of garbage. Like, look at this. Fun texture to that. Like, what should we do with that? And then I was thinking these might be nice as like little hanging earrings. They already kind of look like earrings. Just some more boxes and like packing paper. And this is like a tablecloth that I got a bunch of paint on, bunch of plastic. Oh yeah, this was like plastic with reflex. Got some styrofoam, which is honestly my arch nemesis. I literally hate when things are packed in styrofoam. Some bubbles, bubble wrap, some cardboard. Yeah, just like lots of things like this. It sounds nice. With the recycling program that we do here, we could probably legitimately recycle about 90% of this. We would just have to take it to a recycling depot and sort it all out. But like I was saying at the beginning, I know there's a lot of people who don't recycle, and then in that case, all of this would just be put in the garbage. So I think it's important like to touch on that removing garbage from the ocean is great, and that's what we need to do. But then so that we're not adding a bunch into the ocean, we need to recycle. I know it doesn't cure everything and they probably won't use everything and reuse everything, but it's what we can do to help. But we don't need to recycle these because we're reusing them. We're making an outfit, which I wanna show you my inspo. So I've been watching RuPaul's Drag Race UK and Crystal Versace made this outfit. And I feel like with all of the cardboard I have and a little bit of like the used tablecloth, I think we could try and cook something like this up. Definitely not the same colors or anything, but I like the bodysuit and then like the big spikes. And then once we get it done, I will put on some makeup that suits it. But that's the goal, people. That's what we're aiming to do today. Do you think I'll be able to do it? Probably not. But let's get garbage shopping. Okay, so this is what I've chosen to start with. Let's see what we can make. So first, I will be attempting to make a corset. I found this template online, and I'm going to follow that. Chip is also in here. Jimmy, my little pumpkin, my little pumpkin. Okay, I need to get on this. So, corset, cardboard. They both start with a C, so we'll build them together. About this. I think maybe this would be better because it's bendier. Dang it! Just realized that I probably shouldn't have used this hard fabric because it doesn't really hug the body. I mean, it's not terrible. I have kind of like a pointed boob moment, but I'm wondering, maybe I should redo it onto this. No idea what I'm doing. Wow, what a beautiful execution of a corset. Oh my gosh, it looks great. I'm gonna get so many paper cuts working on this. Okay, this is my base. I'm just gonna build on this. I kind of forgot that I do have to cover up top, so I'll have to sort something out for that. I just did something that I'm actually kind of surprised that I executed. So I put these up to cover my bust. And then I actually bent this one, like I cut into it and then bent it and glued it into itself so that it actually curves to fit. Whoa! Seamstress extraordinaire, right? Now I need to be sparing with this tablecloth because there's not a lot of it and I need to cover everything in it.
Maybe it would be better off
in the garbage. I don't know at this point. I'm hoping they defy gravity a little bit like that. So let me just like apply a lot of glue. I have never related to RuPaul's Drag Race contestants more when they get red to filth on the runway. Like, I get it. Okay, I think this is generally gonna be the silhouette. I have to make lots of accessories and add some fun texture to this because I have like stuff like this, which might look cool. And then like maybe a skirt of plastic. I don't know. I don't. But yeah, it's going okay. I wouldn't say I'm confident in my garbage outfit, but it lives up to the name. That's all I gotta say. Then I'm going to spray paint this. Now that is pretty much cheating because the spray paint isn't garbage, but I just really hate this print on here and I obviously don't have any other things to use. So I am gonna cheat just a little bit to spray paint it and then use like a little bit of paint on it, but I'll show you guys that. Sorry. Sorry that I'm a cheater at that. I haven't unbent my back for a while, like when I was working, and now I think my back is like a bit seized up because I went to the chiropractor this morning. Oh my gosh. Anyways, the show must go on. So there's the garment down there. Here's what it's looking like. I was thinking about doing white spray paint and then I would draw on it with paint, but I have quite a few colors, so let's see. There's black, pink, gloss, gold, white, or orange. I think white. I'm gonna open the garage door for this. Now, I'm just gonna make a bunch of accessories because I feel like when your outfit's not great, just add a lot more and no one will notice. Words to live by, people. All right, you guys, it's the next day. It dried really well, so now I have a little bit of paint. So this is, again, this is the cheating portion. I'm gonna paint like a fun design on here. I kind of don't know what I'm doing yet. Probably just like squiggles and polka dots, but we'll see how it goes. And I don't have my makeup on yet because I'm gonna get into the whole thing later. So excuse this. Okay, well, this is amazing lighting. I just finished painting. It took like, I don't know, 2 or 3 hours, but I really like how colorful it is. So let's do the glam. Okay, while that is drying downstairs, I'm going to get into the drag look. Now, obviously, I'm not a drag queen, but I do admire and I am inspired. So yeah, it's gonna be like heavy inspiration from that. But the makeup inspiration I actually found on Pinterest. Here's the picture. So let's just get the complexion on and then we will get into the fun stuff. So complexion. Okay, complexion is on. How was that transition? Be honest with me. Now, with this picture, I feel like my eyebrows don't go that high. Like maybe if they were like that, then I would have that much eyelid space, but I don't have a ton of eyelid space. So we're gonna have to make this work. I'm already second guessing, but I'm gonna zoom you guys in. Let's get started. Okay, I'm gonna start with white eyeliner for safety, just to try and sculpt it out a little bit before I go in with any like serious colors. So let's just jump in, right? But really you just have to look good from far away. That's kind of a rule of thumb in life that I've lived by. Just look good from far away. I feel like that looks not bad, so I'm impressed. Okay, now to do it on the other eye. So even it out. Oh my gosh, why is this going well? What's happening? I just got a really thin black eyeliner because I see that in the inner eye corner, it gets very thin. I feel like I'm doing this in a really weird order. Oh my gosh. That tickles so much, holy. How do people make this look good? I will never understand this inner eye thing. Oh my gosh, it's so tickly. Oh, ooh, that is tickly. I just wanna like itch it. Okay, I'm gonna actually do that the whole way. Okay, you know, I was kind of feeling like it was going too well, so it makes sense. Hopefully we won't have another issue like that. Today I have been like drinking a lot of water on purpose because I feel like the last couple days I've drank like so little water in a day. So today I was like, I'm gonna drink the daily dose of water and like really do that. And every time I walk by a washroom, I have to pee like without fail. So I may be hydrated, but I've also given up a lot of time peeing constantly. Now that we have this white line, we're gonna fill it in with purple. Kinda hurts my eye to like look to the side so much. You know when you're doing eyeliner and you're like, and it's like, it hurts to look out the corner of your eye that much. This looks terrible. Why does it look so bad? I swear it looked kind of better with the white. Okay, that took a weirdly long time softening all the edges. So I'm just gonna do what I did to this eye, to this one, and a few other things. I feel like it's not that exciting. So I'll just do it off camera, but hopefully I can pull this together. I'm gonna start with this and it's gotta kind of like go down. Okay. Now I'm gonna put white in my waterline and also kind of like in here. Put that on my lid just to add a little bit of excitement. That's actually really pretty. What the heck? My dad is calling. Hello?
2 seconds later.
All right, I am just putting on my mascara. I was just talking to my dad on the phone. Can you hear that dog just like endlessly barking? My neighbor's dog just won't stop. He's just so excited about something. Okay, I have to be 100% honest. I'm not loving the makeup. I loved it on the picture. For sure. Maybe it's my outfit and hair though. So I'm gonna put on a wig and then we'll put on the outfit that I made out of garbage and we'll see. So I need to pick a wig. This one's probably the easiest wig to wear. So I'm leaning towards it. Obviously it needs a little brush. A little comb out would really help. Oh my gosh, this looks bad. Obviously it needs a little brush as well. These honestly haven't come out of the box since the move, so they're all a little bit rough. But this one's like a long moment. It's gonna look a lot better, I swear. Gives me very much Halloween vibes. I mean, that one's clearly the most fun. Clearly. But does it go with the look? I don't know. I'll decide on the wig. And then we're gonna hit the main stage. So I'll see you on the main stage.
Oh my God.
That was a choice.
Are those boots Prada?
Why are you being cute?
Your features and your face are beautiful.
Category is duct tape.
Sudden movements, anybody? So, what do you guys think of my garbage look? Try to ignore the tape. It turns out that this dress did not defy gravity, so these didn't stay up. So I just had to tape it, which I'm pretty sure my skin is reacting to, but it's fine. It's better than flashing the entire internet. I think if I had a little bit more materials, a little bit more time, and a lot more talent, it could have looked a lot better, but it's not bad. Like a drag look on a budget made of garbage. I really like the silhouette, but honestly, I didn't account for the bottom half of my body. I just thought these little triangles would cover me. But as you could see by my underwear in every frame,
I needed to make pants.
I think painting made it a lot more visually interesting and a lot more fun. I should have probably painted the insides as well because they actually do show, which I didn't think of, oh my gosh, should I connect these? Is that something? But yeah, I think this video was a lot of fun, kind of random, but at the end of the day, it's better looking like this on my body than in the ocean. So if you guys are interested in getting more garbage out of the ocean, make sure to click the link to the Team Seas donation page. And I hope you enjoyed watching. I'm very interested to hear what you guys think of this look. Just remember that I made it out of garbage and remember my talent level, okay? Be nice, please. But as always, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed and I will see you guys in the next one.